ご一緒です。
かわいいよ。
I hope you all are fine at home. Yes or no?
So,
today we'll discuss chapters that about of India, independence in India. In last class, we have discussed the chapter freedom struggle, India freedom struggle movement. So, in this class, we'll discuss about the independence India. So, in last class, how much we have discussed that up to 1815. So, whenever Mahatma Gandhi come to India from South Africa. Mahatma Gandhi come to India from South Africa in 1915. So, he started his journey from South Africa in 1914 and reached to India in 1915. So, then, they starting the Gandhian era. Is that the starting the Gandhian era? And it is the way to that from here, from in 1915 to our freedom. Our freedom, way of our freedom is going to start. Our way of freedom is started from 1915. So then Mahatma Gandhi come to India. That as you know that Mahatma Gandhi is first movement against. So what the first movement and movement of Mahatma Gandhi, that is Champaran. Yes or no? That is the place of Bihar. Champaran, it is the place of Bihar. Where? It is in Bihar. That place is in Bihar. That Champaran. So that is about of the green. That is the, it is actual movement about the farmers. That is the green planters. About the blue planters. About the blue planters. So वहाँ पे बहुत इंग्रेज लोग थे, वो क्या कर रहे थे ना, इंडियंस को ज़्यादा टैक्स दे रहे थे, जो ब्लू प्लांटर्स थे उसमें से उससे ज़्यादा टैक्स ले जा रहे थे. तो उसके हिसाब से उसके अगेंस्ट में एक मूवमेंट किए थे, दैट इज नोन एज चंपारण. ओके, इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज ब्लू रिवेलियन, ब्लू मूवमेंट. सो द ईयर 1905 वाज द क्रिशियल इन द इंडियन स्ट्रगल फॉर फ्रीडम. इट इज द गांधीजी रिटर्न टू इंडिया फ्रॉम साउथ अफ्रीका. आई हैव सेड इट इज 1915, where Gandhi started the Satyagraha movements in India. First, that is Champaran, the next non-cooperation movement, civil disobedience movement, Dandi March, Quit India movement, okay, Rowlatt Act, Rowlatt Act. The so many movements are started by the Mahatma Gandhi after this. Okay, so something we'll discuss about the biography of Mahatma Gandhi. Actually, Mahatma Gandhi is born in 2 October 1869, at the poor bandar of Gujarat. Where? In the poor bandar of Gujarat. Gujarat ke poor bandar place hai. Wahan pe Gandhi ji paida hue the. Whenever? In 2 October 1869. Clear? Clear, yes. So, that after this, so Mahatma Gandhi actually is a law student. Yeah, complete his law in the Calcutta, and then he have gone to London, then he have read here, then there is a case against, aap ek case ladne ke liye gaye the, kahan pe, South Africa mein, going for a case, something case of his friends, for a business case, for this Mahatma Gandhi going to South Africa for some. So there he has stayed for 15 to 20 years. So after that, in 1915, Mahatma Gandhi come to India. So Gandhi and the freedom struggle. Okay, what is the related? Before also we know that 1857 we are starting the revolt. From 1857 we are started the fight against British. But what happened after 1915? Whenever Mahatma Gandhi come, what happened is that time? So that our Indian, that is change our way of India, independence. Why it is open up our way of independence? That is not, but what is happening? That is something work done by Mahatma Gandhi. Okay, so we will discuss in this class it is. So, in the South Africa, first we'll something know about of South Africa, Mahatma Gandhi, about South Africa. He is very much successful in South Africa. बहुत सारे अच्छे काम किए थे गांधी जी. कहाँ पे? साउथ अफ्रीका में बहुत सारे लोगों को मदद किए थे. ओके, सो जब वो इंडिया आए थे कौन महात्मा गांधी जब वो इंडिया आए तो देयर इज ओनली वन थिंग्स दे हैव कटेड एवरीवन दे हैव ओनली वन थिंग फाउंडेड एवरीवन दैट इज पॉवर्टी व्हाट इज पॉवर्टी गरीबी उसको चारों तरफ गरीबी दिखाई दिया इसको महात्मा गांधी को इंडिया में चारों तरफ क्या था गरीबी था वहां पर ठीक है क्या था गरीबी दिखाई दे रहा वहां पे सो इट इज वेरी मच पेनफुल टू महात्मा गांधी एट दैट टाइम सो सारे इंडिया को घूमने लगे चारों तरफ देखने कहां पे क्या है सो उसे क्या मिला वहां पे पॉवर्टी मिला दैट इज वेयर फाइट अगेंस्ट ब्रिटिश एट दैट टाइम सो ही रियलाइज दैट लॉन्ग ऑफ देम हैड डिवाइडेड द रिलीजियंस कास्ट ब्रिटिश विल रिमेन मोर पावरफुल ही आस्क्ड द पीपल नॉट टू फॉलो द केस caste system the people were not powerful even against the British Raj is wanted common language to link the entire country so Mahatma Gandhi is requested and to suggest to the people that don't believe in the caste system that don't believe in the caste systems we are one we are unit so whenever you to unit that we can fight against British jab hum ek ho sakte hain जब हम एक हो जाएंगे तभी हम ब्रिटिश के अगेंस्ट फाइट कर सकते वी कैन अचीव सक्सेस वी कैन गॉट इंडिपेंडेंस सो ये था हमारा महात्मा गांधी स्टार्ट किए थे एंड हिज नॉन वायलेंस एंड हिज मेन द मेन मोटिव इज दैट इज नॉन वायलेंस व्हाट इज नॉन वायलेंस दैट्स द मेन मोटो महात्मा गांधी अहिंसा बाय गोइंग बाय हु इज नॉट दैट वायलेंस वे वी डोंट have to follow the violence way that is non violence we have to achieve our independence with the help of non violence that is the best main motto of Mahatma Gandhi so there is written here first Jallianwala massacre when that is Jallianwala Bagh that is very important for you for your exam point of view Jallianwala Bagh that is in Punjab where it is in Punjab Jallianwala Bagh That is actually the place, Jallianwala Bagh. I am saying about the story of Jallianwala Bagh. It is a place of Punjab of Amritsar. What happened in there? So in 13 April 1919. In this day, that is happening the Jallianwala Bagh massacre. What is this actually? Actually, that is a celebration. Kya ek celebration ho raha tha? Baisakhi day. India ke ek, hamare Punjab mein ek. बैसाखी डे सेलिब्रेशन हो रहा था तो उस दिन क्या हुआ तो बहुत सारे लोग वहां पे इकट्ठे हुए थे दैट इज लार्ज नंबर ऑफ पीपल्स आर टुगेदर इन वन प्लेस दैट इज इन जलियांवाला बाग जैसे एक मीटिंग चल रहा था वहां पे तो वहां पे क्या हुआ सो मोर देन 20,000 पीपल्स आर गैदर्ड इन देयर हाउ मेनी मोर देन 20,000 पीपल्स आर गैदर्ड इन देयर इन जलियांवाला बाग प्लेस So, at that time, that is British governor appointed a governor general Dyer, governor general, his name is General Dyer. So, he has said to his army to shoot to all the people here. There is no silence about that. Without any, General Dyer, he decided to teach the Indians a lesson. हाँ मैं क्या सोचा था जिन जो प्रोटेस्ट कर रहे उसको एक आज लेसन देंगे किसको इंडियंस को तो उसके आदमी को सूट एंड ऑर्डर के लिए इशारे दे दिए तो वहां पे सूट करने लगे दैट्स ऑल द इंडियंस दैट इज मोर देन दैट इज द हंड्रेड ऑफ सिविलियंस आर किल्ड एंड मोस्ट पीपल आर इंजर्ड इज देयर ओके यहाँ पे ऑफिशियल रिपोर्ट में कुछ ही 1000 समथिंग पीपल आर डेड बट इन द नॉन ऑफिशियल रिपोर्ट देयर इज मोर एंड मोर पीपल आर डेड बाय दिस फायर मोस्ट आर इंजर्ड दैट इज वो हमारे जो इंडियंस थे जो इंडियंस लोग को बहुत ही टच हुआ था आई टच सारों तरफ ऑल इंडियंस आर ओके द ऑल्स आर फाइटिंग दिस इट सो ये जनरल डायर थे जो काम किए थे सबको ये क्या हुआ था सबको मरवा किया गया ठीक है सो नॉन कोऑपरेशन मूवमेंट सो नेक्स्ट अपन नॉन कोऑपरेशन मूवमेंट What is non-cooperation moment? All subjects are underlined. Will not cooperate to British government. Will not cooperate to British government. That is means non-cooperation moment. Whenever it started in 1920. When 1920. Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi to start here. It is stated by the Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, Mahatma Gandhi, in 1920, that is non-cooperation movement. Or why? Due to the Jallianwala. Due to the Jallianwala incident, that Mahatma Gandhi started the non-cooperation movement against British. Okay. So thousands of students are left their schools and the social workers. Have service persons, lecturers, doctor, advocates, all have rejected their jobs and joined the movements. So Gandhiji wanted this movement to be peaceful and non-violent. So that is main motto I have said before also. That is the main motto of Mahatma Gandhi at the time. That is non-violence. What is non-violence? So there is a one incident happened in that time that is very much maintained the incident took place in Chorachori that excited Gandhiji, felt sorry and decided to. So what happened in 1922? Whenever he started that movement in 1920, but in 1922 one incident happened in the Uttar Pradesh. In Uttar Pradesh, Chauri Chora. That you may know about the incident of Chauri Chora. That is a place that the peoples are very much angry about the police officer at the time, and they are close to the one police station. That is 22 police are killed by the peoples. 22 police ko wo thane mein band karke aag laga diye the. Isse 22 पुलिस अफसर वहां पे मारा गया थी। तो महात्मा गांधी सोचे थे कि उस टाइम में जो हमारा इंडियन लोग जो नॉन वायलेंस इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ नॉन वायलेंस के बारे में कुछ थोड़ा बहुत शायद उसके बारे में पता ही नहीं है। तो महात्मा गांधी स्टॉप द मूवमेंट ऑफ नॉन कोऑपरेशन मूवमेंट स्टॉप हियर इन 1922 आफ्टर द इंसिडेंट ऑफ चौरी चौरा। ओके so next withdraw of Simon Commission one commission come to India in 1927 that is known as Simon Commission Sir Chapter Simons one person of British person he have taken that commission to India that is known as Simon Commission so that is a commission that is come to India that is Simon Commission it is come to India in 8 November Simon Commission it is 8 November whenever in 8 November 1927 that is come to India that is Simon Commission but who is Sir John Simon this commission is under Sir John Simon one person of British that sent to India for this Simon Commission. No Indians remember when the Simon Commission arrived in India in 1922, the people back at it is greeted with a blah blah. Whenever Simon Commission come to the India for development and for development of the Indians and investigation about the Jallianwala incident, but Indians are opposed to the Simon Commission and they are to black flag. They are so black flag to the Simon Commission and they have said Simon go back and they have said that Simon go back. They have said Simon go back. One thing is it is okay. Simon go back. At the time of relation between the Hindu and Muslim back there is very growing wars. थोड़ा थोड़ा डिस्टर्बेंस स्टार्टेड होने लगा था, इसमें से हिंदू एंड मुस्लिम द रिलेशन बिटवीन हिंदू एंड मुस्लिम। सो इन 1812 भगत सिंह एंड बिकेदर्स एक्सपोर्ट ऑफ बॉम्ब्स ऑफ द फ्लोर ऑफ सेंट्रल असेंबली। यस सर, अनदर पर्सन ऑफ नेम दैट यू मे नो अबाउट भगत सिंह दैट थ्रोन बॉम्ब इन द असेंबली इन द सेंट्रल असेंबली that except Bhagat and Rajguru and Sukadev were sentenced to death. So there are three persons, Bhagat Singh, Rajguru and Sukadev. In 23 March 1931, they are hanged. उसे फांसी दे दी गया। Whenever in 23 March 1931 को उसे क्या किया गया था? फांसी दे दिया गया था। That's three persons, Bhagat Singh, Sukadev and राजगुरु, क्योंकि ये सेंट्रल असेंबली में बम फेंक दिए थे, दैट वाज दैट यंग एज, मतलब उसे डेथ का सजा दे देगा। मेनी पीपल सन दैट डाउन फॉर देयर दिस फॉर द मैच। तो फॉर दिस इंसिडेंट दैट भगत सिंह सुखदेव और जयराज को जो फांसी दे देगा, द इंडियन साइड प्रोटेस्टेड अगेंस्ट इट इज मोर एंड मोर पावरफुली। सो अनदर थिंग्स इज कमिंग देन एट द लाहौर सेशन, दैट्स पूर्ण स्वराज कंप्लीट इंडिपेंडेंस। We need that complete independence. हमें क्या चाहिए? पूर्ण स्वराज चाहिए। Then we are saying that we need the complete independence. हमें क्या चाहिए? पूर्ण स्वराज चाहिए। The resolution was passed and the British 1932 started civil disobedience movement. So in 1930, another important point that in 1930, that is Gandhiji started the civil disobedience movement. For this पूर्ण स्वराज complete independence, the main motto is that complete independence. Then Mahatma Gandhi started in 1930 the civil disobedient movement. Clear? Okay. So then in this also, in 1930 also, you know that is Dandi March. About the Dandi March, Mahatma Gandhi started the work of in Sabarmati Ashram to Dandi. Yes or no? That is for the break the law act, सोल्ट एक्ट को तोड़ने के लिए और गांधी मार्च गांधी साबरमती आश्रम से गांधी तौर पर मार्च किए थे। दैट इज ऑल्सो इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट्स फॉर यू। सो टुडे विल डिस्कस दिस मच, इन नेक्स्ट क्लास विल डिस्कस रेस्ट ऑफ थिंग्स। तो चिल्ड्रंस टेक केयर, बाय बाय, सी यू नेक्स्ट क्लास।